Hey, UCF's had trouble getting SEC teams to play them. They don't want to play them. I'm just wondering, how does this roster stack up with SEC?
Right now?
Yeah.
I mean, we'll beat somebody like Auburn, for sure. Like, we'll beat Auburn for sure. But, like, no, man.
You didn't play in the Peach Bowl against UCF.
Yeah, I did.
Oh, didn't you?
Yeah, I did. I was a freshman. Yeah, so, yeah. I mean, it's a lot different, a lot of different, you know, players and caliber guys, but I ain't gonna lie, we'll be a team like Auburn.
You think this program has a chip on its shoulder?
Oh yeah,
like
for
you
sure.
Did?
For sure. Yeah, that's why I came in. That's why I was looking for a team, you know, looking in for, you know, that a team had, like, things like that. That was some of the characteristics that I was looking for a team, and I feel like UCF had it, and so that's why I came.
What do you say about this program when you, not just yourself, but you got other guys who went Auburn who wanted to come join Gus? I mean, what does that say about kind of coming Gus here and trying to,
yeah, it's really Gus. I mean, like I say, like, over the 3-4 years that I've known him, just relationship he's built with his players is something that I think is really important, and something that he's taking more important, you know, that he you know, he loves to do, he want to do. And that's something that, you know, that I think a lot of guys don't get in, a lot of coaches, that guys that are sitting in the head coaching position, that they don't get that kind of affection and, you know, relationship type of thing with their head coach, and I think that's the biggest thing.
Was it unfairly, because his getting booted, I guess, at Auburn, was that unfair? I mean, did you feel like that was kind of unfair for him?
I honestly did, because it was COVID year. Like, everybody had a bad year. We didn't even, you know, it was... But hey, you know, it's a business, you know, so you have to look at it like that. But I honestly think, you know, he should have got another year, because of COVID. Everybody had a bad year. So, you know, so.
You're looking, he got a nice little bio.
Huh?
He got a good bio.
Yeah, he did. He did.
Looking for a place to go after everything. I know originally thought you might go to Tennessee. I know there were changes happening there too. Obviously, when Gus got the job here, what were those early conversations like? Did you have to think twice, you know, when Gus reached out to you?
Oh, I did.
What was that process like?
I did, because it was UCF. I told him when he first got a job, I told myself I wasn't coming. I was like, I'm not going to UCF. And he called me, and I was, you know, I was like, all right. And he gave me a plan. He said, I'm going to call you back with a plan. I was like, all right, call me back with a plan. He's like, okay, we're going to do this, do that, get recruits here. We're going to do this, do that. And I was like, all right. And he called me back. Then T. Will called me, and they just kind of like told me the whole plan. And I was like, okay, I'm gonna do it. Cause like I said, I was going to Oklahoma. I didn't feel comfortable going all the way to Oklahoma for like 6 months. Like, it was 2 months to get out there. I was like, nah, man. I kept praying on it. Then Gus called me, and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna go to Orlando, and how it happened.
So it's good that you had a relationship built. You know, you didn't want to go to some place brand new where you didn't know anybody. So that obviously helped a lot, knowing Gus and T. Will and working with those guys. And you had some former teammates that eventually joined you as well.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So how excited are you just for your final year? I mean, what do you want to accomplish out there on the football field?
Everything. I want to show the world. I ain't got to show the world. Prove to myself that I'm the best defensive player in the country. I am the best defensive player in the country. I was the best defensive player in the country last year. I just got hurt. That's the only thing, you know, but, you know, I'm going to wake everybody up, and you know, I'm going to show them. So, you know, the proof is in the pudding. So that's all I got to say.
Did you eagerly look at the American and kind of see what the competition
is? No, I don't care. Like, I would have did the same thing in the SEC. Okay. Like, I don't care. Whoever lined up against me is going to get this work. Every play, every down, every second. Hey, as long as I'm healthy, they're gonna get the best of me. So I'm saying, like, we're going to have a great front seven, definitely special for this conference. I think I don't see us losing, you know. And I honestly think, you know, all of us going to eat. Everybody's going to have success, including linebackers, safety, everybody. I feel like everybody's going to have a great time this year. Man, I just look forward to it.
What are some of the top reasons you think a young guy should want to come here to UCF and play for Gus?
Just the thing that he's preaching, the things that he's trying to do for players, you know, of course the new NIL deal, you know, like things like promoting guys, trying to get guys out there, you know, not just, you know, I think that's the biggest thing, and just the relationship that he builds with his players. I mean, you want, like I said, a lot of programs don't have coaches that actually talk to them or have, you know, that you rarely talk to them, and a lot of programs are like that. Now, I honestly think, you know, that's one of the biggest things when it comes to, like, you know, recruiting and things like that. You want to know your head coach. You want to know things like that, to know who runs your program. And I honestly think he brings a lot of that, all that to the table.
Are you a guy that has personal goals? Like, you say, I want to have this many sacks. I want to be all conference.
Yeah, I want to be the best player in this conference. I'm going to have over 15 sacks. I don't know how many TFL. We're going to see how that goes. But, you know, 15 sacks, that's the goal. That's the goal.
I appreciate it.
For sure.